Today we're going to connect a camera to the Raspberry Pi 4 Model B for the first time. I have the Smraza or Smraza Raspberry Pi 4 camera module. We'll also take a look at the picture and video quality, and I'll mention one of the problems I had along the way. Hey everybody, I hope you're doing well. I just wanted to show you this camera that I got for the Raspberry Pi. I got it off Amazon. It's about 20 bucks. I don't expect a whole lot from it, but I just want to see how it works with the Raspberry Pi. And it is the Smraza camera module. Open it up here. We've got the camera module here. We've got a cable for the Raspberry Pi Zero, which I will not be using. I don't have one. And we have a little warning here. Do not plug or unplug the camera while the power is on. Okay. Or that'll happen. All right. So with that out of the way here, we'll take out our module. So in the bag, we have the camera module and a cable here to plug into the Raspberry Pi. It does come with a lens cover, and this is 5 megapixel at 1080p. It's also got a wide angle option. It has a viewing angle of 160 degrees, which is pretty wide, so that sounds pretty nice. It also has a fisheye option. I don't really care much for fisheye, but if you like fisheye, hey, this camera has it. All right, now that we've talked about this a little bit here, let's connect it to the Raspberry Pi and see how it looks. There are a number of these Raspberry Pi cameras online, and you have to pay attention to which side the blue strip is on. Here, the blue strip is on the front, the side with the lens. On many of them, the blue strip goes in the back. So this was already attached when I got it. So for any reason, you have to reattach it, or if you take it out, just remember the blue strip goes on the front there. Next, we're going to locate the camera slot for your ribbon, and it is between the HDMI port and your headphone jack. And if you look at it, there's a thin, a gray piece that runs the length of that camera slot. You're going to lift that up to loosen it. You don't want to take it all the way off. You want to be careful. And it should wiggle just a little bit, just like that. And what we're going to do now is take the ribbon and slide it in there firmly. We're going to make sure the blue section down here is facing me, and we're going to put it in. It's going to be on the side of the headphone jack, on the side of the USB ports, and you want to seat it down in there just right. Make sure it's level, and then you want to push that plastic tab right here back down in there to clamp it in place, and it is a firm hold. Yeah, it won't be going anywhere. It's pretty firm. After it's attached, it should look a little something like this for this particular camera, where the lens is facing the back. The lens is facing away from the Ethernet port and the USB ports. It's facing toward the side with your SD card. Well, that was easy enough. It's time to go ahead and hook up our Raspberry Pi, turn it on, and see what this camera looks like. Now that we're at the Raspberry Pi desktop, I want to show you my first attempt to get this to work. And there's nothing wrong with doing it this way. I went to sudo raspi config, and I scrolled down to the interface options, and then I selected the camera, and I said yes, I want to activate it or whatever. So then I back out, and I reboot the system with sudo reboot. I had previously installed the 64-bit beta version of Raspian. Now with that said, every time I tried to access the camera with a test.jpg, I would get a command not found response. I then did an update and then upgrade. I searched all my folders to see if anything was out of order. To make a long story short, I had to go back to my PC and reflash the 32-bit version of Raspian and start all over. It made it much easier. Well, I'm back with the 32-bit Raspian installed, and this time I'm going to go up here to preferences and Raspberry Pi configuration and activate the camera this way. I'm going to scoot on over here to interface and then make sure the camera is enabled. Go down here. Once you hit OK, you'll get a command to reboot. So you can go ahead and type reboot into the command line here. Alright, I'm back from the reboot. I'm going to go up here and open the command terminal. And I'm going to type in raspy-still-o-test.jpg, or JPG. And here we have a brief moment before it takes a picture. And that is a horrible painting above my monitors. And if we go up here to the folders, click that, we can see the JPEG right here. And that's the picture that it took. So that was pretty quick before it took a picture. Let's say that you want 10 seconds before it takes a picture. So we can go back in, type in raspy still, dash T for time, 10,000. 10,000 milliseconds is 10 seconds. Dash O, test.jpg. And I have 10 seconds before it snaps that final photo. Actually, the video is not bad for this camera. And if we go back up to the folder here, it will be right there. That's the photo I just took. There are other capabilities and commands that you can use when using the still shots like this. And for that, you can go to Raspy Still. You can open up your terminal here, type in Raspy Still space dash dash HELP, and it'll give you a list of everything. Now for video, instead of ending the command with a JPG, we're going to end it with H.264. That is the video encoding capability that Raspberry Pi uses. So we're going to use raspy vid space dash o space test dot H.264, and that will allow us to access the video function of our camera. And here we're going to have a very quick video, and it's going to go back, and that video will appear in our folder right here, and you can access it just by clicking on it. Well, that video was very short, and much like the command that we used for the still shot, we're going to use the same type of command to lengthen that video for the video, the raspy vid. So we're going to go back up here to our terminal, clear this out, and we're going to do raspy vid dash T for time, and we're going to do 20,000. 20,000 milliseconds is 20 seconds, dash O, test.h264, and that should give us 20 seconds of video with our camera. The camera quality appears to be okay. It's a lot like our old cell phones. It doesn't react all that well to bright lights like looking out a window, but overall for $20, it's really not that bad at all. And after you've seen how messy my desk is, we can go back here, and that file will be up here where all the other files have gone, and you can access it that way. Same quality. I think it does a pretty good job. But all your pictures and your videos will be there in your files, unless you delete them. Just like the still shots that we were doing earlier, you can go to the help section for Raspy Vid, and you can look at the other commands and capabilities. We'll explore those in future videos, I'm sure. Or at least some of them. But yeah, so you just type in Raspy Vid dash dash help, and the screen comes up. Now there is a command that I used that helped me determine that the ribbon from the camera wasn't all the way in the Raspberry Pi. And what I used was vcgencmd space get underscore camera. And you'll see something pop up that says supported, it should say 1, detected, it should say 1, If yours says supported zero, you have a software issue. If yours says detected zero, that means it's not reading your camera. You probably need to put your ribbon in. Well, that's all I've got for today. Hopefully this was helpful for you. It was helpful for me just to go through it. I do appreciate you watching and all those comments you leave. So until next time, stay safe, have a good week, and I'll see you again with another video.